Hi, I'm John from the bada team of Samsung Mobile. In this video, we're going to look at how to use sensors to drive the user interface of your app. We'll introduce the UIX namespace and the classes and interface it provides. Then we'll show you how to use sensors in your application by looking at some sample code. This video should help get you up to speed with bada development. Make sure you check out our blog at developer.bada.com and keep an eye out for the rest of our videos on YouTube. Using sensors in addition to traditional input mechanisms can really improve the usability of an app, especially games. Gesture input or tilting the device can be used in addition to touch controls for navigation or scrolling through content. Games can be controlled using body movement or trajectory mapping. These are just a few of the many ways sensors in mobile devices can be used to enhance user experience and control. The UIX namespace contains the classes and interfaces for UI extensions. In this video, we'll look at the Motion, Sensor Data, and Sensor Manager classes, and the iMotion Event Listener and iSensor Event Listener interfaces. The Motion class allows an app to monitor the movement of the device. There are three kinds of motion events: snap, shake, and double tap. The snap motion event occurs when the device is moved along one axis and back. The shake motion event occurs when the device is moved quickly back and forth multiple times. And the double tap motion event occurs when any part of the device is tapped twice. One example of how an app's UI can be enhanced using motion controls is a multi-touch drawing app. We're going to modify our app to respond to shake and double tap events. Shake will clear the screen, while a double tap of the device will undo the last operation. To detect device motion, we'll use the Motion class and implement the iMotion Event Listener interface in our Form class. When our form is initialized, we create an instance of the Motion class, register the Motion Event Listener, and set the Motion instance to monitor for double tap and shake events. When a double tap motion event is detected, the listener's onDoubleTapDetected method is called. In this method, we undo the last drawing operation. We restore the canvas to the previous drawing state. When a shake motion is detected, the listener's onShakeDetected method is called. We check the motion state and clear the canvas when the shake motion has ended. Let's have a look at our drawing app with these changes implemented. The Sensor Manager manages the device's built-in sensors. An app registers a listener with the Sensor Manager to get sensor data. The listener polls the sensor for data and either delivers it to the application at a specified interval or when the data has changed. A device can have various physical sensors. Bada provides support for the acceleration sensor, the magnetic sensor, the proximity sensor, and the tilt sensor. The acceleration sensor measures the device's acceleration vector in three axes, X, Y, and Z, relative to its body frame. The magnetic sensor provides the magnitude and direction of the magnetic field around the device by using the data from the X, Y, and Z axes. The proximity sensor detects the presence of nearby objects, and the tilt sensor provides data related to azimuth, pitch, and roll. You can test out sensor input in the emulator by using the event injector. Choose to inject values for the accelerometer, magnetic tilt and proximity sensors, and see the result before you deploy to a device. You can also simulate double tap, shake, and snap motion events. The availability of sensors in the emulator depends on the type of device you're developing for. For example, the tilt sensor is not available for HVGA devices. Another example of how an app's UI can be enhanced using sensors is playback control in a media player. We'll be modifying the MediaPlayer sample application from the SDK to add playback control using the proximity sensor. If the device is turned over, or if an object is placed in close proximity, the video will be paused. To handle the proximity sensor, we'll use the Sensor Manager class and implement the iSensor Event Listener interface in the VideoPlayer class. When the VideoPlayer is initialized, we create an instance of the Sensor Manager class, check whether the proximity sensor is available on the device, and add the sensor listener. When a proximity sensor event is detected, the listener's onDataReceive method is called. In this method, we check the value of the sensor type parameter and retrieve the data from the sensor data object. If the proximity sensor value is true, this indicates there's an object close by, and we send a request to pause the video. Otherwise, we send a request to resume playing the video. Let's have a look at the media player with this new functionality. The use of the proximity sensor demonstrated in the Media Player app is a simple example of using sensors, because the value returned by the proximity sensor is either on or off. Our next example uses the tilt sensor. We're going to create a spirit level, which displays a bubble indicating whether the device is being held level. Our form derives from iSensorEventListener and implements the sensorEventHandling methods. In our form's onInitializing method, we initialize an instance of the sensor manager and check the availability of the tilt sensor. If the tilt sensor is available, we retrieve the maximum interval and add the sensor event listener. In this example, we're using the interval and data change parameters to specify that the tilt sensor data must be sent to the application at the requested interval, whether the data has changed or not. The tilt sensor provides data related to the azimuth, pitch, and roll. These values can be used either individually or in conjunction by an application to determine the position of the device. In our Spirit Level app, we just use the pitch value reported by the sensor to determine the position and movement of the device around the z-axis. When a tilt sensor event is detected, the listener's onDataReceive method is called. In this method, we check the value of the sensor type parameter and retrieve the pitch data from the sensor data object. Now, because the onDataReceive method is called by another thread, not the application's main thread, we shouldn't actually call any app APIs here. But although the performance isn't guaranteed, we want to update our spirit level to reflect the current tilt value, so we call the main form's requestRedraw method to trigger a redraw of the form. We've overridden the form's onDraw method to do some custom drawing. We then use the device pitch parameter returned by the sensor listener and determine where to draw the bubble on the screen to indicate the device's level. To perform our custom drawing, we first retrieve the form's canvas using the getCanvasN method, and then draw the background of the spirit level. After drawing all the bitmaps, we have to remember to delete the canvas object from the heap. Now let's have a look at our spirit level in action. In this video, we showed you how to use sensors to drive the user interface of your application. We introduced the bada UIX namespace and the classes and interfaces it provides, and we showed you how to use these within your applications. Keep checking our website for recipes, technical notes, and the sample code used in this video. Thanks for watching.